This is Patrick Bailey with WhiteboardCoder.com. Today is April 9th, 2015, and I'm going to go over JSON schemas. Now, the first thing you want to do if you're looking up JSON schemas is just go do a search for JSON schema PDF. And hopefully this guy comes up first, this Understanding JSON Schema PDF. And, well, here's the URL. I'll just leave that up there. This guy, Michael, and I'm going to pronounce his last name wrong, Droteboom, wrote a great article on understanding the JSON schema. Now, JSON, unlike XML, doesn't really have a schema from the standard, but they've created a schema, and now it's up to version 4. So you can create a JSON schema in JSON to check your JSON. And this document is real simple. He's done a really good job on this, so I'd recommend go download this document and read it first. In the meantime, if you want to start playing around with it a little bit, there is a JSON schema lint.com, and actually if you go there directly, it sends you right to draft 4, so perfect. So what it does here is you can actually put a JSON schema in here, and then you can put a JSON document in here. So if I do this, actually that should check out because there really is no schema. So I've been doing some Node recently, and I've had to do some JSON checking, so I had to go learn some JSON schema. So I'll copy and paste some of the stuff I've been doing over here. So with the JSON schema, what you can do, you can define, first of all, what type of, this is not a necessary field, but you can define what schema version you're using. And here I'm using draft 04, which is the current one. You can give it a title, and then you can say what you're looking for. So let me just copy everything I've done over here. So in this case, what I'm doing, I'll bring this down a little bit. Boom, boom, boom. Okay. Here, what I'm saying is I'm looking for an object, and I want in that object to have a field called message. Let me get rid of that one too. A field called message that is a string type. And let me get rid of that one too. Okay, now it's a little simpler. So I'm requiring a JSON object that is required to have a message parameter that is a string. So now I can go over here, and now that I have a valid schema, I can put in a JSON to check against. So I can come in here and do message 42, and that's invalid. And in fact, this JSON schema lint website set up pretty well, so it just says, hey, you got the wrong data type. Put in that, boom, it's valid. Now the way this is written, it does not check against, it won't check against additional information. And so I can do something like this. Add another piece of data, and it's not gonna validate that. That's just extra pieces of information, and this schema as written is not checking against that. And a lot of times that may be what you want to do. You may want to validate your incoming JSON, but you don't want to break it. You don't want to break it in case you add extra information. You may just want that to go through. But if you do have the case where you want a really strict schema definition, you can come in here and say additional properties to false. Now what that says is you have to define every single property you want in there. If it's not defined, it can't be in there. And see, here it says you have additional properties. Now I got to remove it. Now I can also come in here and I can do a regular expression based on this guy. So I can do a pattern. And I'll show you how I messed up earlier with this. I did a regular expression like that. Oh, there we go. And that's valid, but I kind of messed up my regular expression here because that will check for hello anywhere in the document. And I actually wanted it to actually start with hello. To start with hello, you have to do this. And it's just me forgetting some regular expression stuff. There we go. Now it has to start with hello. So now we are testing against our regular expression. So that's fun. Here, I'll add another field in here. I'll add an email. And I'll come in down here. I've already done this. Let me just copy and paste this guy in here. Okay, so add an email field. And what I have said is it's going to be a string format, but it needs to be an email. So this should reject it. It says it must be an email format. Now you'll look over here. I didn't do a regular expression. I didn't do a pattern in a regular expression. I did a format in an email. Now it goes over, this has gone over in his document, formats. Let me go do a real quick search and see if I can find that section. There we go. Built-in formats. So the JSON schema has some built-in formats it can check against. It can check email. I don't have to go find a regular expression. I can just refer to email. It's got a date time, host name, IPv4, 6, and a URI. So I can go in here with that, choose email, and now I don't have to go find some funky regular expression. It's already in there. And it checked. And so if I do that, oh, hey, well, maybe that's not a great email checker. I take that back. Huh. Maybe I gotta go look that up. Okay, let me take a second to look that up. It's using the email against this internet email address. RCF 332. Okay, after poking around a little bit more, it looks like at least this validator doesn't work very well on emails. Because if I do this, if I do me at example.com, it validates. But it also validates example, at least for this guy. So that's not good. Poking around, I found this, and here's the address. I'll put a link up to it. Now this guy has a list of valid email addresses and some invalid email addresses, so it's probably good to check against. For example, at example.com should be invalid. And I got a feeling if I put this here, oh, hey, it says invalid. That passed, but this one is invalid, and it passes. It looks like the standard is okay, but it could be the libraries you're using really aren't adhering to it very well, so maybe you might need to use a regular expression. That's a little disturbing to me. That's not even an email address. It's valid. Well, maybe that's not as nice as I would like it to have been. But let me try their IPv4. So I can say, try that. Do address. And I'll add an address. So let me add an address. 1.1.1.1, and we'll change that email to IPv4. That should be pretty simple, right? Data.address. Oh, too many S's. There we go. So an IPv4 address, that should be simple, right? Validated that. Aha. Okay. So a simple one like that may be easy to use, but the email one, I don't know, I guess you gotta test your library to see if it actually tests it correctly. This one's not, so maybe you have to use a regular expression for that guy. Anyway, there's a lot of other neat things you can do with this schema checker. Go check out this document here. It's a good document. Read through it all. And there's a lot of cool little details you can get out of there. And that's it for this one.